now section 4.4, we're going to be solving exponential and logarithmic equations. So we have to know those rules, and we have to know that definition. So those are like the five things I'm remembering. The definition of log, and then those four rules that we just talked about. Those are the things that I need to know in order to solve these equations. Okay? Are there questions like this on the extra credit? Pretty sure there are. There's some simplify, combine. Should be at least one. Okay. So, same base, same log. Okay, so if I have, if b to the m equals b to the n, we already talked about this last class, then m has to equal n, right? Similarly, if log base b of a equals log base b of b, then a has to equal b. That makes sense. Right, 2 to the first equals 2 to the x, well, x has to equal, you know, right? The exponents have to be equal, just like whatever's inside there has to be equal. Okay, so number 1, 2 to the fourth equals 2 to the x, that means x has to equal 4, right? What about number 2? Those aren't the same base. Can I write them as the same base? Well, this is 2 cubed. What about 32? Is 32 2 to the something? 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, times 2 is 16, times 2 is 32. So it's 2 to the 5th. So what do I do with these exponents? Quick refresher of rules of exponents. What do I do with these? Multiply. So 5x equals 3. Divide both sides by 5, you get x equals 3 over 5. All right, you guys do number 3. Did I get it right? Does it make sense? So I'm just using these this property up here. If I can write this, if I can have something as the same base, then I can set those exponents equal to each other. A better way to do it, though. Well, maybe it's not always better, but because this is pretty straightforward, right? But another way to do it is to solve is using these four steps. So first, so this is the way to solve if the bases are not the same. So isolate the exponential expression. That means get my base 2x or x plus 2 or my exponent alone. Get it to equal other stuff. Take the log of both sides of the equation. Log for base 10 and ln for other bases. Then simplify using properties of logarithms. So that's those four properties from the last section and the definition. And then the last step is solve for the variable. All right, let's do this. So here I have 2 to the x. I have isolated the exponential. 2 to the x equals other stuff. It is isolated. Now I need to take the log of both sides. All right, let's do that. I'm taking the log of both sides. Okay, so now it says simplify. So I could have done log or natural log. For some reason, I did log right now. Now it says simplify using properties of logs. So what? How can I simplify this? What properties do you see? Well, do I have multiplication or division inside of log? Nope. Do I have a definition? No, because I have log equals log, right? Do I have change of base? No. So do I have the exponential property? Yep, there's an x, there's a power inside of log. I can bring that power out in front. That is the exact reason we use log if our variable is in the exponent. That is the only way to get the variable out of the exponent, is to do log and then use the exponential property of log. Log of 15 equals x log of 2. Log of 2, what does log of 2 equal? Hmm? 0.30 something, blah, blah, blah. Ugly number. I don't care, but log of 2 is a number. What about log of 15? 1.17 something. Barf. It's an ugly number, right? So I have a number equals x times a number. Now I'm solving a linear equation, right? This is a linear equation in terms of x, right? If I gave you a question like 5x equals 7, you know how to solve this in your sleep. This is super similar, just super ugly numbers. Log of 2, you guys said it was 0.7 something something, ugly. Log of 15, 1.7, ugly, right? The thing is that these are numbers. If I ask you to solve this, you can solve that. We're doing the same exact thing, just our numbers are just a little uglier. Okay, so we're going to divide both sides by log of 2. So I get x equals log of 15 over log of 2. If your homework says enter the exact answer, this is your exact answer. If the homework says round it to the 10th decimal, whatever, round it to some decimal place, you put this in your calculator. And what do you get? 3.90689. Something, right? So either of these are acceptable answers. Okay, why don't you guys do number 6? So again, if I didn't have directions and it just said solve, I need to recognize that the exponent, the variable is in the exponent. In order to get the variable out of the exponent, I need to take the log. So let me take the log of both sides. Again, you can do log or natural log, but here I have base 10, so I definitely want to do log. I took the log of both sides, right? I have the exponent, the exponential expression isolated. Now I want to take the log of both sides. Now I want to simplify. That's the exponential property of log, right? That's what I definitely need to do in this situation. What's the log of 10? What do you mean cancel? It equals 1. Log of 10 equals 1. So this is x equals log of 8.123. If you put that in your calculator, what do you get? 0.0 super ugly, right? What is it? Huh? 90 something something. Either of these are acceptable answers. I personally like the log answer better. All right. So now we have some more similar equations, right? I've isolated the exponential. So number 7 is very similar, right? Yeah? All right. So it's a little different, but I've isolated the exponential. Let me take the log of both sides. So I'm just mentally going through those steps, right? Do I want to do log or natural log? What do you guys think? Natural log because I have e. Definitely do natural log. If you have base 10, definitely do log because nice stuff will cancel. So let's do the natural log. Okay, now I can do the power rule, right? What do you guys think? What's the mistake I made? It's not a mistake. You can keep it. Amelia? Why do I need parentheses here? Good, because that is the exponent. I'm bringing it out in front to multiply. I'm not bringing part of it out in front to multiply, right? Good. Here, in this case, ln of e is 1, so you would have still gotten the right answer. But if this was base 2, it would mess up your answer, right? So make sure you're multiplying by that exponent. So Kehlani said ln of e is 1. Now I have a linear equation, right? I have x to the first power. The way to solve x to the first power, everything with an x on one side, everything without an x on the other side. Okay, so I'm going to subtract 1 from both sides. Now I'm going to divide both sides by negative 8. Subtract. It's a plus in front of 1, right? You were looking at this minus, yeah. So ln of 1, 0, 2, 3 minus 1 over negative 8. So don't bring that minus 1 inside. Don't do craziness like that. This is the answer, which you can put in your calculator and get something equally as ugly. All right, you guys want to do 8 or you're good? It's the same exact process every time. We're going to skip 9 and 10. But this is the same exact process every single time. Do you have a question? Can we do 8? Okay. All right, you guys try it on your own. We have the exponential isolated, right? I'm going to do natural log.
Why?
Why not? So here it says do log for base 10 and ln for other bases. So the thing is that's what you're supposed to do. For number 5, it didn't. We did log instead of ln. It didn't really matter. Okay, so I took the log of both sides. Now I need to bring the exponent out in front on both of them. Okay, so again, I'm at the point where I have a linear equation in terms of x. Let's write down something similar without log, and you tell me how to solve this. Right? Log of 7, log of 3 are just numbers. Super ugly. Don't like looking at them.
but they're just numbers. This is a linear equation in terms of x. I solve it the exact same way. So how would you guys recommend solving this? Distribute? I would distribute first, right? Okay, so let's distribute our stuff on both sides. And then we're going to have, like this one, we would have 21x minus 7 equals 16x plus 8. In order to solve this now, I would get everything with an x on one side, everything without an x on the other side. I'm not doing the exact same problem, but I wrote a similar structure instead of ln of 7 and ln of 3. Those are just numbers. We know how to solve this. Just because this one has ln, don't let it scare you. It's the exact same process that you guys have been doing, that we've been doing all semester, right? That's what I'm trying to show with this example. So now I get everything with an x on one side, everything without an x on the other side. So I'm going to add and subtract from side to side. So I subtracted this from both sides, and I subtracted this from both sides, right? So now I have everything with an x on the left-hand side, everything without an x on the right-hand side. Right? So now what do you guys think I should do? Factor out the x. Good. So that's the point of getting everything with an x on one side. Now I have x times super ugly number. The opposite of times super ugly is divides by super ugly. It's a mathematical term. Make sure you guys write that one down. So I get x equals 2 ln of 3 minus ln of 7. So super ugly, I could put it in the calculator. I could do those rules from section 2.3 to make it look nicer, but I could just leave it like this too. All right, so class is over.